And we're back. So last time, well, time before last time, Bertrand got away in a helicopter. But Cole was able to mess it up real bad, and here it is. It's crash landed right over here in front of the bridge. And let's just see if we can find Bertrand. Or Bertrand's body. Or, you know, parts of Bertrand's body. Look, as long as we can identify it as, like, Bertrand, that's good. Just like a hand or a tooth or something. That's more than enough.
Oh, there is no way he's walking away from this one. Hey, old man! Breathing in here? Where the hell is he? What the hell? Okay. No way.
Gee, I wonder where we need to shoot this guy. Not entirely sure. I don't know. Guess we'll have to figure that out. Must be a puzzle fight or something. Oh, you gotta shoot him in the big glowy part. Oh, okay. We can do that. Hey, where'd the helicopter go? It's kinda gone. So this is a big dude. He's got a bunch of different moves. Hey, you can shoot the big green goop. It's a pretty annoying attack, actually. He's got a few other moves. See if we can't get him to do them. Like, oh, yeah, this one. That cannot smell good. So the real way to do a lot of damage to this guy is to throw cars at him, but I'm not a great shot with the cars, so I'm gonna just try some other things. Also, the militia are actually trying to kill this guy, which is nice. They're actually gonna ignore Cole and go after this dude. They've got their priorities in order. That's pretty good. So this guy, at least to me, is not easier as good or evil Cole. Neither one of their bolts are really great for this dude, and the grenades, you gotta get real close, and you don't really want to do that. He's got some moves if you get too close. Like this one. He just starts eating people. It's not a fun move to get caught in. He can also spawn these dudes. And he can even spawn normal humanoid-sized corrupted as well. Probably do that at some point. Calling him a he. Just assuming. There might be a dick in there somewhere. I don't know. I don't want to know. Please don't tell me. I'd rather not know. I want to confirm that information. So the behemoth has a fixed path, I think. I think it's fixed. It doesn't really deviate from it a whole lot. What are you wearing? No, don't go that way, you dumb... Oh. This is just Darwinism acting right here. Let's try to get a car in there. Don't want to wait too long when he exposes the weak spots, because does hide them pretty fast. But we've kind of seen all this guy's moves. He doesn't have a ton. Also, the more weak spots you destroy, the more annoying the fight gets, because the mouth one and the chest ones are pretty easy, but the elbow ones are kind of a pain, just because you're not at the right angle, you're not going to have enough time to get them, and they're kind of a little harder to hit with a car. A little bit. At least I think they're a little harder. Oh, didn't quite get there. Oh well. Yeah, you kind of seen this whole fight at this point. It's actually not... It's not a really interesting boss. At least I don't think it is. Just kind of... I mean, it's a cool-looking dude, but the fight itself is just kind of dull after a little while. But that's okay. He's almost dead. Artillery bolt is kind of good, because you don't want to get too close to this guy. Want to kind of keep a bit of distance, and that bolt's pretty useful for that. But none of the bolts are great. Even the bolt stream is not a great bolt for this guy. It's okay. It's not amazing. Just trying to get some grenades in there. That didn't really do a lot. Oh. Grenades don't do a lot to this guy. That's unfortunate. But, you know, let's just finish this thing. Let's get back over to good Cole, and let's just end this fight. Almost down. No, it's mine. It's my kill. I was here first. I saw the giant titan monster first. It's my kill. Called it. Dibs. I got superhero dibs on this. There, good.
What's the matter, big man? You done?
The stinking gas, the howling, it was nothing compared to the filth inside. Bertrand, I alone saw his true face. Oh, that guy can run all he wants. It doesn't matter. I know his secret. And I am coming for him.
Yeah, that's one of the few cutscenes in that style that actually does have good or evil Cole in it.
Hey, man. With Bertrand over in Floodtown, I'm guessing you want to head on over. I'll get the Transformers ready for you.
Oh, boy. It's the third to last district. Wait, no. There's four. This is the third one. Second to last. I'm confused. I've confused myself. I'm not good with the numbers. Well, we're pretty far into the game. That's what I want to say. That's right. So, hey, Floodtown.
Hey! Heard you're fixing to bring the power back on in Floodtown.
Look, I know you need help out there, but I'm after Bertrand.
Oh, two birds with one bullet, huh? Oh, I like the way today's shaping up.
So we gotta do the thing here. Gotta power it up. And can you spot the edit? Did you see it? That was some ninja editing right there, I tell you what. So we got a bunch of experience. Let's buy a new power. Let's buy a really good power, actually. Let's get Evil Cole the napalm grenade. It's actually better than the double grenade. It's a tough act to follow, but it totally does. The napalm grenade is great. It's just the impact. It's got a lot of force behind it. Just tosses dudes around, does a lot of damage. It's a really nice grenade.
This is some bad news.
Just grab this real quick. You better not say anything nasty. Very sensitive man, Evil Cole. We've established this. Don't hurt his feelings. It's just not nice.
People in Floodtown have had it rough. When the levees broke, we lost everything a person loses. Homes. Our past, our loved ones. I lost my wife. Somehow that flood didn't stop us from helping our neighbors. Somehow it brought out the best in us.
First the flood, then Bertrand's militia, now these ice freaks. Oh, it's about time these people caught a break.
Cole, spoilers? We're not fighting ice freaks yet. God, Cole. Just ruining the whole game for everybody. So if Pokemon taught me anything, fire is super effective against ice, right? That's how that works.
Great. What are these guys doing here?
Word in the militia is that those ICE guys used to be mercenaries. Came here all the way from South Africa. Ever since you busted them out of that underground lab, they've been acting crazy, attacking everyone they come across in Flood Town. I'm guessing they lost their minds after what Bertrand did to them.
They're organized crazy people. That makes perfect sense. They're also all over the place, so we really want to be careful here. Because the Icemen are pretty neat, but they're also pretty annoying to fight on hard. The Icemen are actually, like, completely new and different enemies. Isn't that awesome? It actually is. But they have a lot of annoying things they can do. Fortunately, Flood Town does have water all over the place. So you can use that to your advantage, but it can also screw you over. If you're fighting a bunch of guys and you fall in the water, you might just die. Might just happen to you. Let's try to avoid them for now. They will be just hanging out like that. Oh, come on, Cole. There you go. These guys are kind of in the way, so let's do this. Yeah, the water is very handy. These guys don't seem to realize that water and electricity is not a great combination. It's just not a good thing. Well, now they know. Well, this is Cole trying to teach these guys a lesson. I don't know how great of a science teacher Cole would make, but well, he would show you things. Be very hands-on. He'd also probably kill you. Like, really horribly, painfully kill you, but you'd totally learn some stuff before you died. You'd take it to your grave, which would happen very soon. But you would take it to your grave. Not many teachers can say that. But Dr. McGrath... Alright. So like before, gotta fend off a bunch of guys. We do have pretty much unlimited power right now, so. And with the water, this becomes pretty simple. Do you need to get on your toes with these guys and be ready to blast them? Because they will get a little close and you just want to get them out of the way. Don't really need to focus on killing them, though. Just keeping them away for long enough and then not dying for the thing timer run out. That's all you gotta do.
McGrath?
Hey, Quo. Listen, I know you're probably pissed at me.
It happened. Okay, it happened. You chose Nyx. Obviously the wrong choice. But you're a guy, and guys suck at thinking with their brains. So, I guess I'm saying we still have a job to do, so let's just concentrate on this.
Yep. Quo called. So you can imagine what's going to happen here, right?
How do you feel being this wrong, Cole?
Hey, Nick. This is Quo.
Everybody screws up sometimes. The bigger the man, the lower he may fall. Maybe it's a one-time thing. Or maybe you just a fool.
I've been called worse.
Not yet. Just don't screw up again, all right?
Nyx, it's nothing personal. You didn't know Ice Launch. It's that simple. You didn't know the best power in the game. If you knew the best power in the game, I would have totally did the thing, but you didn't. Let's buy the ice grenade. Ice grenade's pretty cool. Check it out a little later. But, well, I don't think it's as good as the napalm grenade, but it's pretty neat. It kind of creates little temporary cover for you. You throw a bunch of grenades around. It's not as good as actually hiding behind stuff, but it's something. Once again, the ice launch is immensely useful for getting around Flood Town. Especially right now when there's no power. I mean, there are a lot of grind wires. There's a lot of ways to get around here, regardless of whether you have the ice launch. But it's handy all the same. There's a lot of cool scenery in Floodtown. It's a pretty cool looking place. It's not just, you know, a city. It's actually different. The game is actually, like, not exactly the same thing. Because it kind of was sort of the same thing for a little while, but now it's not. Now it's different. That's good. Good job, Sucker Punch. So we gotta do the same thing here we just did. Just after I said the game is actually different, we gotta do the same thing again. This should be super easy, because we got Boltstream. And there's lots of water. Did you guys call dibs, though? You gotta call dibs. You can't say it's yours without calling dibs. That's just how it works. So there's a few different types of ice guys. There's normal ones with, like, machine guns. There's ones with RPGs, of course. And there's also ones with shotguns. And those are the guys you gotta watch out for. Because they like to just run at you really fast and shoot you in the face. And that sucks. So if you ever see a red square moving unusually fast, like that guy, you gotta shut that down. You don't want those guys getting too close. Almost there. Just a little more. Got this.
I guess you must have met our new landlords out here. Used to be the militia control of Floodtown. Now these ice goons have taken over.
Why would anybody fight over this defense? No offense.
They've been tearing Floodtown apart since they got here. Looking for something.
Editing! It's so seamless. So this is the last Transformer. It's also the easiest one? Yes, I think it is. And look where it is. On one side you got buildings, the other side you got water. And the dudes can't come from the water side, so it's a little easier to defend. We gotta get there first, though. Let's try to sneak past these men. Look, I know I've been doing an assault run, but I'm gonna do a ghost run for now. Get some more points than usual. No, I gotta get past this man. Ah, there you go. Didn't play all that Splinter Cell Blacklist for nothing. It's pretty much the same game. I mean, I'm wearing, like, dark clothes. I got electric powers. It's the same game. Hey, let's zip up the building really fast. Oh, right, there's no power. Oh. Well. So with this one, we're just going to hide behind it. Because I don't think they can blow it up, like, from gunfire. I don't think they can. I'm not positive, but I'm pretty sure they can't do that. And we're just going to blast guys away. Just sit tight, and... gotta work on the landing there. It's not easy landing with style, but you gotta get that down. That's the wrong thing. That's not... left on the D-pad. Down is not left, silly. Okay. And that killed, one guy? Maybe? Let's just pretend like it killed one guy. Oh, was that a no crosshair precision hit? Is that what that just was? You should invent a stunt for that. That was impressive. That's what that was.
Heard about this med station LaRoche put together? Word on the street is you've got a cure for the plague.
I'm heading over. Figure I'll help out. You should join us.
A little busy here, Zeke. But not for much longer. So I haven't really been late any of these guys. You don't really want to? You can, but it's not a great thing. They're pretty hardy. You probably noticed, the ice guys. Got a lot of health. Takes a lot to get them down. And they got these shields, and that's just no good. And usually when you get close enough to melee, they just jump away. That guy didn't. He had something to prove, but they usually will. So you got a cure for the plague, huh? You know, when I electrocute people, it heals them. So clearly, we've already got the cure to the plague, right here. I just do this to everybody in the city with the plague, it'll be cured. Look, trust me, I'm a doctor. Dr. McGrath.